our world really shifted in many ways in 2022 with the James Webb Space Telescope. And I wonder if you could explain, first off, what is the JWST and why did that rock your world so much?
Right. So the James Webb Space Telescope, or JWST for short, is a space telescope that NASA and some international partners launched on Christmas Day in 2021. And it is a very large space telescope. It's the largest space telescope ever built. And it can do a lot of different things for astronomy, but for the study of exoplanets, its main strength lies in its ability to characterize the atmospheres of planets. And from the standpoint of searching for extraterrestrial life and looking for life on these exoplanets, characterizing the atmosphere is the really key thing that we have to be able to do. And so that, okay, in a nutshell.
Can you explain that? Why is the atmosphere the it?
Right. So if you take a planet like the Earth and you put it, you know, the distance from the sun that it is, it's getting this certain amount of energy. But if you didn't have Earth's atmosphere, the surface of the Earth would actually be freezing cold. It would not be suitable for liquid water. If the Earth had a different kind of atmosphere, the surface of the Earth could be way too hot for surface liquid water. So the atmosphere, through the impact of the greenhouse effect, modulates what the surface temperature is. And so the composition and the thickness of the atmosphere tells you whether you could actually have life on the planet. And then beyond that, the atmosphere can encode what kind of life exists on the planet. So for example, oxygen in our Earth's atmosphere is a sign that there's photosynthetic life here on the Earth. And that's something that remote observers with enough precision and sensitivity could see that in Earth's atmosphere and deduce the presence of life. And so for these exoplanets, that's the thing that we want to be able to do. We want to be able to see the composition and thickness of those atmospheres. We want to be able to calculate what the surface temperature would be on these planets, given the amount of energy they get from their own host stars. And then we want to look at the different chemical species that are in the atmosphere. And we want to be able to see, you know, is there a smoking gun evidence for life, you know, among those chemical species? So the way the James Webb Space Telescope explores the atmospheres of exoplanets is by a technique called spectroscopy, which is just spreading the light out into its different wavelengths and seeing which chemical species are absorbing at different wavelengths of light. James Webb was the first telescope that we could use to search for the signature of CO2 in a planet's atmosphere. And so we saw this specific chemical spectral fingerprint of CO2 in the planet's atmosphere that we were looking at. And that was really exciting because just first of all, it showed the discovery power of the telescope. In the very first data set that we took for an exoplanet, we discovered something new that we had never seen before. And on top of that, CO2, even though we detected it in a gas giant type planet atmosphere, it's actually a really important gas in the atmospheres of terrestrial planets. The terrestrial planets of our solar system that have atmospheres, so Venus, Earth, Mars, they all have CO2 in them. And so they're a real interesting molecule to look for in terrestrial planets. And so we could see it in this gas giant type planet really easily. And from just extrapolating how sensitive our measurements were, we thought, yes, if it exists in terrestrial exoplanets, we could see it in their atmospheres as well.
And what would your reaction be if, number one, you found the atmosphere and then actually you found oxygen in that atmosphere?
That would be a really exciting discovery because I would have pretty high confidence that was coming from life. Now, to back up a little bit, right? Mm-hmm. Oxygen in Earth's atmosphere is created by photosynthetic life here. Oxygen's highly reactive. If all photosynthetic life, God forbid, on Earth ceased to exist in this moment, the oxygen would be pulled out of the atmosphere by chemical reactions with surface rocks in just a few 10,000 years, tens of thousands of years. So a very short amount of time geologically. And so oxygen is something that has to be continually replenished by life here on the Earth. And so it's a type of gas that we call a biosignature gas, something, right, that's caused by life. Now, understanding oxygen as purely being due to life requires understanding more of the whole planet context. It requires knowing what other kinds of gases are there. It requires knowing what kind of star the planet's orbiting. And ideally, you'd like to know that you're talking about a terrestrial planet as well, although that may not be required. And so if I saw oxygen in the atmosphere of a planet, my questions would be, right, is this a terrestrial planet? Is it a planet in the habitable zone? what other chemical species are present in the atmosphere, and what do we know about the star and its history and how it's irradiated the planet over, you know, several billion years, more than likely. If we could put all that together, right, we could have a credible picture of life being on that planet. But simply the detection of oxygen would already be pretty exciting, even though there are false positive scenarios for oxygen, you know, not being caused by life. Those are sort of edge cases. The most likely explanation, if we see oxygen in the atmosphere of a terrestrial planet orbiting another star, is there's life there. And that would, I think, be sort of earth-shattering type scientific discovery.
Okay. Now, when we talk about there being life, that may not actually be the type of extraterrestrial humanoid-like life that I think people jump to in their imagination. It could be a cellular level of life. Is that right?
I think that's actually most likely. Okay. And in fact, the presence of oxygen in an atmosphere doesn't indicate the presence of complex animal life, right? The oxygen in Earth's atmosphere is created by fairly simple photosynthetic life. The oxygen in Earth's atmosphere about 2 billion years ago was first put into the atmosphere by cyanobacteria, right? So that would be the main thing that we would expect to exist on that planet. That's what we could say based on the detection of oxygen. Now, oxygen being in the atmosphere makes it possible for complex animal life, right? We couldn't have complex animal life here on the Earth without all that oxygen in the atmosphere that's caused by cyanobacteria, first of all, and then slightly more complex of photosynthetic life right now, right? And so that would be a really interesting thing would be, okay, if we could identify that there's any kind of life on the planet, what sort of evolutionary stage and level of complexity is it at? We could start answering, you know, asking and answering those questions as well.